Musicians all the time. If it's of interest, love to see you. Good.
Great.
I tend to go to the back door so I can see the lighters.
Yes, yeah, yeah. Thanks.
You don't have to say that a lot. We'll go say,
say hello to Jesse and meet.
Yeah.
Say what? Okay, sure, sure. Yeah, good to see you. Yeah.
Thank you. I like that they have a little kids area at the front.
They have something like that at the United Church. Yeah, see, how nice is that?
Well, because for some people it would be distracting.
It would be distracting.
I think so. But
let's get rid of the kids. This is very simple. I know that the United Church, that the other, like the one in Maple Ridge, like they were doing,
they have something like
Lego
that.
And
Yeah.
Snow.
Yeah, I remember Lego. That. That was for adults too.
That was for everybody. Yeah. But this is a good idea.
But I mean, it's a great way to, I think. It was also very deliberately to engage children,
yeah.
Too,
yeah.
So that the children were a part of it. You should introduce yourself to the pastor.
Oh, yeah.
Dan? He was speaking of himself in the third person as Dan.
Hey,
good day, sir.
How fun.
Yeah.
It's a long drive to come all out here.
Okay. Worth it. Worth it. Yeah, good job.
Oh, I see. We had one run through yesterday. So it's like, okay, let's go.
That'll do.
Yeah,
it was good.
We tweaked a few places. So, you know, some places, I just wish I knew what I was doing. I was soloing. I was just like, okay. You know, it's much easier when there's a whole band.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah.
But you're the band, you're like, okay, I'll do, you know.
You can hide when necessary.
You know, yeah, it's okay. I felt like I did it. I was adequate enough.
No, you sounded like I wouldn't have guessed only one rehearsal.
No, you rehearsed yesterday. Yeah. We did rehearse beforehand.
Okay.
So we've had more than we've run through the Pacific Theater. We don't ever get one run through the theater. No, that was fine.
I like the last one best.
Yeah, I don't know. Did he write that?
Yeah, he wrote it.
Oh, did he? Okay, because on that chart, it doesn't say anything. This is printed out unlike everything else.
Oh,
is this a published piece somewhere?
Maybe.
No, I guess not.
Or maybe he just took the chords and wrote the lyrics.
Yeah.
I mean, it was.
Yeah. Well, I mean, the fact that the Beatles song is even a Beatles song.
No.
I think it was like Beatles.
Is that the music band? Yeah, okay. That's what I was thinking. I was thinking, because as soon as I heard it, I was like, that's.
My friend.
But I was trying to place it. It was Music Man is what I came up with, but I wasn't
exactly
sure.
It is.
Okay.
Yeah, my friend played Harold Holm.
Yeah.
Okay. Professional production of that.
Cool.
And I saw him this summer in Toronto, so I was looking like that. Oh, yeah, here we go.
Let people know
that
the Beatles did that song.
Yeah.
That's fine.
But, people who know music, they don't like
I don't think we, I think we ran it once yesterday. Maybe we ran it today. It's like, oh, we know
that.
Yeah.
Let's hope.
So, how was your show? Was it getting it going again?
Yeah, I mean, there's all this stuff to order a new headliner from India, and then I have to replace Shure wireless. And I'm getting it for guitar, because the one I have is it's not in 40s. It's like, and when I was using a photo shoot, I think it was a DFC and a GF. It has a kind of sunburst, kind of a dark spray around the edge. So I picked up a Martin that's Mahogany Martin, and we made those in the 30s. And it's the same, similar size. And then it has that cover, so it has a good retro feel.
Yeah.
I wanted to videotape this just out of COVID, and I couldn't because the kids are 3 weeks on tour. Mm-hmm. And I couldn't get it done. Now I have a couple of days as I'm doing now. I did one more pass, and I'm going to do two shows. So if I videotape both, I need to kind of pay some of these guys. Anyway, yeah, but there's a lot. I've got 42 shows to get to. Starting after, well, that's my normal. It used to be the norm before pandemic because I did 230 shows that year previous.
Wow.
So, but I do three of them in schools. So it's boomed up. We set up, take it down, set up. And we also do some theaters this spring. And I'm doing a math screen, which is the first place I'll do after the pandemic. Yeah, this lady from Ukraine is going to do the second half, because the show's 50 minutes. Mm-hmm. And she's a classical pianist who tours Europe. She's raising money for the university she used to teach at. And so she'll come and do some, like, about 30 minutes after. Mm-hmm. Considering there's, because there's Ukrainian immigrants in the show.
Yeah.
Fleeing a war zone. Yeah, it's just, it's sad.
That would be meaningful. That would be meaningful.
You know, it was intensely meaningful for us when we came out of COVID to do the show. Because the people hosting the show were exactly the same. We're in the descendants of Stalin's. And this is 12 years before the
wow.
So it was so intense to do the show for them. Anyway, it's nice to have something that has some inspiration.
Mm-hmm.
I'm pretty thrilled. Another thing that's really cool is my friend Ross, he passed away in cancer. He used to tour with me in the audience shows. And he used to work at Barker. Do you know what Barker is?
No.
It's in the center of BC. It's
okay.
And it's out of the 1860s.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of the earliest big settlement in BC because the Victoria was there.
Right.
And they found so much gold. They started going to the road, developed a cattle, turned it into the colony. Anyway, Ross was there for 10 years.